Welcome to Eye Care Central. This video is on Hirschberg test. Hirschberg test is also known as corneal light reflex test. It is done as part of squint examination. It is an easy, simple, and quick test. The only equipment that is needed to perform this test is a point source of light, like a torch or a pen light or a direct ophthalmoscope. Hirschberg test is performed from a distance of 2 feet or 50 centimeters from the patient by shining the light at the glabella of the patient. Glabella is the point between the two eyebrows. The patient is asked to fixate on the source of light and the light reflex in the two eyes is examined. Hirschberg test is performed with both eyes of the patient open. The pupils must be undilated. Hirschberg test is never done in dilated pupils. So we observe the position of the light reflex in the two eyes. Light reflex appears as pinpoint white light on the cornea. It is actually the first Purkinje image that is formed on the cornea by the reflection of light from the anterior surface of the cornea. Hirschberg test gives us three important pieces of information about the patient's ocular alignment. First, whether the eyes are aligned or not means does the patient have squint? Second, in case squint is present, what is the direction of squint? And third, the rough estimate of the amount of squint means how much squint is present in the patient, what is the measurement of squint? So in a patient with normal ocular alignment, means someone who does not have any squint, the light reflex falls in the center of the pupil in both eyes, means the patient's eyes are straight. Now if we look at this pic closely, we will notice that the light reflex is not falling exactly in the center of the pupil, it is a bit decentered. That is, it is slightly nasal to the center of the pupil. This decenteration is usually 0.5 mm and it is due to angle kappa. Angle kappa is the angle between the visual axis and the pupillary axis of the eye. Also, if we compare the light reflex in both the eyes, we can see that this decenteration is present in both. So the light reflex in the two eyes is symmetrical. Both are decentered nasally by a very slight amount, and for all practical purposes, this slight decenteration of reflex is documented as central or normal. Now in this patient, you can see here that the reflex in the right eye is central, but the reflex in the left eye is falling away from the center of the pupil. So the Hirschberg test is telling us here that the eyes are misaligned. Next, we need to determine the direction of squint. For this, we check the position of the light reflex with respect to the center of the pupil. So this again is normal ocular alignment. Now in this picture, the light reflex in the right eye is central, while in the left eye it is falling temporal to the pupil. We need to remember that the eye is deviated in the direction opposite to the direction of displacement of the light reflex. So if the reflex is temporal to the pupil, that means that the eye is deviated nasally. And we know that nasal displacement of the eye is known as esotropia or convergent squint. So in this case, the patient has a left eye esotropia. Now let's look at another example. Here again, the light reflex in the right eye is central, but in the left eye, it is nasal to the pupil. So what is the direction of squint in this case? The reflex is falling nasally, which means that the eye is deviated temporally. So if the eye is deviated temporally, that condition is known as exotropia or divergent squint. So this patient has a left eye divergent squint or left eye exotropia. So can you tell me the direction of squint in this patient? You can see that the light reflex is central in the right eye, while in the left eye it is nasal to the pupil. So this patient has a left eye exotropia. In this picture, the light reflex is central in the left eye, while in the right eye it is temporal to the pupil. So the eye is deviated nasally. This means that this patient has a right eye convergent squint or right eye esotropia. The light reflex can also be displaced in the vertical axis. So in this third case, the light reflex in the left eye is central, while in the right eye it is falling below the center of the pupil, which means that the eye is deviated in the opposite direction, that is the upward direction. So when an eye is deviated in the upward direction, it is known as hypertropia. So this patient has a right eye hypertropia. In this fourth case, the light reflex is central in the right eye, while in the left eye it is falling above the center of the pupil, which means that the eye is deviated in the downward direction. So this condition is known as hypotropia. So this patient has a left eye hypotropia. Now what happens when the light reflex falls diagonal to the center of the pupil? Sometimes a patient can have misalignment in the horizontal axis as well as in the vertical axis. So here you can see that the light reflex in the left eye is nasal to the pupil, but it is also falling above the center of the pupil. So the eye is deviated temporally as well as inferiorly. So this patient has an exotropia along with a hypotropia of the left eye. Can you tell me in the comment section below which condition of the eye causes both hypotropia and exotropia of the same eye? So moving on, the third information that is gained from Hirschberg test is the rough estimate of the amount of squint. So after we have confirmed the direction of displacement with Hirschberg test, we need to measure the amount of displacement of the reflex from the center of the pupil. 1 mm of displacement is roughly equal to 7 degrees of squint. We know that the normal size of the pupil is approximately 3 to 4 mm. So the border of the pupil is 2 mm from the center of the pupil. 1 mm is equal to 7 degrees of squint. So 2 mm will be equal to roughly 15 degrees of squint. So if the light reflex falls on the border of the pupil, the patient has 15 degrees of squint. If the light reflex falls at the limbus, limbus is the junction between the cornea and the sclera, the patient is said to have 45 degrees of squint. If the light reflex falls in between the border of the pupil and the limbus, then the patient is said to have roughly 30 degrees of squint. This is true for all the different directions of deviation, that is esotropia, exotropia, hypertropia and hypotropia. So these are the different test results you can get. In this picture, the Hirschberg test is central or 0 degrees, which means that the patient does not have squint. It is normal ocular alignment. Second is 15 degrees of exotropia. We document it as LXD approximately 15 degrees. Some people write it as LDS approximately 15 degrees. Third is 30 degrees of exotropia or LXD of 30 degrees. Fourth is 45 degrees of exotropia. What happens when the light reflex falls outside of the limbus? How would you document this amount of deviation? In these cases, we write it as left exotropia greater than 45 degrees. So in this pic, you can see that the light reflex in the left eye is central, while in the right eye it is falling not only nasal to the center of the pupil, but also on the sclera. So this patient has a right eye exotropia that is greater than 45 degrees. And suppose if the light reflex lies here. In this case, the patient has a horizontal misalignment along with a vertical misalignment. So he has 15 degrees of esotropia and 15 degrees of hypertropia. Squint is measured in prism diopters. 1 degree of squint is equal to 2 prism diopters or PD. So if a patient's Hirschberg test is 15 degrees, he has 30 PD of squint. If it is 30 degrees, he has 60 PD of squint. If it is 45 degrees, he has about 90 prism diopters of squint. This calculation gives just a rough estimate of squint. You need to do other tests for exact measurement. How would you report Hirschberg test in this patient? So this patient has a right eye esotropia, approximately 30 degrees. Why? Because first of all, the reflex is central in the left eye, while it is off-center in the right eye, which means that the patient's eyes are misaligned. Second, the reflex in the right eye is temporal to the pupil. This means that the eye is deviated nasally. That is why it is an esotropia. Also, the reflex is midway between the border of the pupil and the limbus. So it is 30 degrees of esotropia, which when converted to prism diopters would be approximately 60 PD of squint. Hirschberg test is useful in newborns, in children, in uncooperative patients, and in patients with poor fixation or eccentric fixation, because prism bar cover tests are rather difficult or sometimes not possible in these patients. So I've tried my best to explain this test to you in the most simple manner. If you have any doubts, please post them in the comment section below. Please like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.